Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel. So in today's video I'm going to be coming to you all about my labor and delivery story. I actually have live footage of what everything that happened, and you know, this is basically me just wanting to explain some more in detail. So I'm going to let you all watch the live footage and everything, and then I'm going to come back at the end and let you know, you know, everything of how I feel, how I'm feeling now, how long it's been, and things like that. So go ahead and tune in. And it's early in the morning, so I had to try to record this while the babies are sleeping. But Zechariah, he's like the one tossing and turning, so if you all hear him, yeah, that's him. I got my tea early this morning too. I made me and Hubby some tea. This is a mug he got me called Bon. It says Bon Voyage from Paris. And this is pumpkin spice with some lemon and honey and coconut sugar. You guys, oh my gosh. If you have a Trader Joe's near you and you don't want to have like regular sugar because it's like terrible for you, like white table sugar is horrible. And if you're drinking white table sugar, you better cut it out. They have coconut sugar and it's so yummy. You don't even taste the coconut in there. And then I get this honey, raw honey from a farm, and it's delicious. So I finally got some chalk and I wrote the verse of the week. I actually put the scripture of the week. I'm supposed to write out the verse, but I ain't got time for that right now. So it's Ephesians 6:10. And I want you all to go in your Bibles and look that up. But that scripture stuck out to me because, you know, I've been going through a little bit of a rough time. But God reminded me of this scripture right here. And to be really strong, be strong in Him. So each week I come to record a video, I'm going to be updating the scripture. And I think that'll be nice for you all, for those of you who are reading your Bibles. And those of you who are not reading your Bibles, to encourage you to read your Bibles. Even if it's just the scripture that I post up here, I want you all to get into scripture and Bible reading because it's so important, especially for your spiritual life. So without further ado, let's jump into this live footage. Hey, so today is Today is December the 15th, and I am currently 40 weeks pregnant, like maybe 2 or 3 days. And so I'm down here at the hospital. I've been having contractions on and off. They haven't really been too strong, but I lost my mucus plug, and so I'm here to see how far along dilated I am. And I'm gonna probably do some walking. So hoping today is the day he'll come out, because it's either between now and Thursday, I need him to come out before then, so I can avoid having a C-section done. It's like 7:30, almost 7:40, so I think it said one of the male doctors will be here today, which I really don't like, but I mean, I'm trying to avoid being with one of the other doctors that are here. I'm not going to put any names on here, but yeah, I'm trying to avoid a certain doctor delivering me, so I guess I got to take what I'm going to have. So, yeah, I'm about to do some walking. Yeah.
Hey, you guys. So, I'm in my room. Well, I'm not in the, like, delivery room. I'm in the little triage room, and they're going to check me. I did lose my mucus plug, like, 2 days ago. And so, I just want them to check to see how far along I am. My contractions are probably, like, maybe every 15 or 20 minutes apart. Sometimes they go to 20, 30 minutes apart, so they're not like right back to back where they should be at, but I just want to see how far along I am and, you know, make sure everything is going well. So I have to put on, you know, the ugly gown I was telling you all about. And yeah, they're going to go ahead and check me. And I decided to wear my twist for delivery. Probably looking kind of crazy right now, but I do my twist for delivery, and then afterwards, I got my little wigs. Pray for me. Well, let me not do this. You know, luck, but pray for me, you guys. All right, I'll check back in a little bit.
Hey, Hey guys, so oh my gosh, I'm actually having a contraction right now. Hold on. Oh, honey, why don't you talk to the one? Right.
Okay, so
now you just want to look at yourself and smile. Say something.
Hello to DJ and Noah and Nehemiah.
Honey, this is you too.
I know you guys at home. I miss y'all and love y'all. And hi, YouTube.
Really? Keep a mess.
All right. Come on, it's time to eat. You gotta, take a walk.
You gotta see me, so you gotta focus it. And so hubby's recording me because I have this situation here, which I hate, but has to get done. So, update, they are keeping me. I am 4.5 centimeters dilated and trying to get to 5. 6 is what they consider active labor. It's crazy because with DJ, they consider 3 centimeters active labor. So I guess within, 2-3 years, it's changed to 6 now. So, yeah, they really want to make sure you are the real deal when you come in. So they are talking about Pitocin. They're talking about breaking my water. And they're talking about walking. So I don't want to do the Pitocin really because of the scar. And I'm glad that the doctor that I have, he's kind of on board. Like, you know, he doesn't really want to do the Pitocin unless absolutely necessary. So I'm going to walk for about 2 hours and get some grab something to eat. And, you know, hopefully I can go to about 5.5, 6, you know, centimeters by walking. And then if that doesn't work, then he's going to break my water. Another good thing is he will be here all night. So I'll have the same doctor. I was kind of worried, like, I don't want him to start and then a whole new person comes in. So, and his assistant, she's really sweet, but she won't be here. She'll only be here till 5, so I guess I'll be meeting a new one come 5 o'clock if he doesn't come till then. But I'm hoping that my labor progresses quickly. I've been having these contractions kind of back-to-back now, so it's kind of like what they want to look out for. And update with Mrs. Zechariah. He was a little tired when he came in, so he wasn't really moving around as much. He was a little worried, but now he's up, he's awake, and so everything's all good. So that's pretty much what's happening. I don't know if they're going to let me record the birth. I do want to record the birth for the VBAC moms out there who are wondering, like, you know, and been worried like how I was, you know, more encouraged and feel a little bit better. I know God is with me. And just going over Joshua 1:9, reading that. I have my Bible here with me, so, you know, hopefully me and hubby will be able to read the Bible for a little bit and do some prayer before things get started. And, yeah, that's really about it for the update right now. Maybe hubby can get some foot feeling. Oh, one second.
They haven't seen a patient who
okay.
Has
you too, so this is Daddy Damien right here. And then kind of show the baby's warmer right here. Let's see if I can focus. Baby's warmer right there. I'm gonna come over here. And right here is the baby's bassinet. This is where the baby will be sleeping. Baby bassinet. And that's where little Zechariah will be sleeping. And a pamper for him. Alright, that's it. We'll be back later with more. So the baby's heart, Zechariah's heart dropped, and kind of got me a little bit scared. So I ran and got the nurse, and she's saying that the baby is kind of getting, he's moving around a lot, so he's kind of getting a little bit tired. So in order for him to have enough oxygen, they had put my wife on some oxygen so he can have the oxygen. So it's not for her, but it is for the baby. So I'm just going to... There's my wife. And,
yeah, it's been a tough process. I've been here since what time was it? 11?
No, we were here since 8, I think.
Yeah, about 8 or 9. 8 o'clock.
They got placed in the room, which was kind of lonely. Yeah.
This is the first time I've ever needed oxygen.
And it's been a tough process. You know, you broke your water manually.
I'm going to worry about 6:30, you broke my water. And now it's 8, almost 9. So they're going to give me till about 10:30. And then they might have to give me some Pitocin if things are not coming along. But I feel the contractions are coming faster now. So still praying I don't get that Pitocin, you guys. But I don't, at this point, I don't know what's going to happen.
Yeah, so just, you just finished praying, and we're going to do some more.
Yeah, you got to put it on you.
Okay. Camera on me now. So, you just finished praying, and we're going to have to pray some more and do a little bit of Bible study in a little bit. And got to get some studying done for my, you know, my stuff. But, yeah, we'll be back in a little bit. And hopefully by then, you know, you'll be going to labor soon.
Yeah.
So. All right, later, guys. Okay, you guys. You know, I'm not too happy right now. You can tell I'm pretty much dressed up in OR attire, and you know, things didn't go exactly how we wanted. Something going on pretty much with the baby, where every time my wife contracts, his heart rate drops. So we're about to go into OR, and you know, we'll see you after that. So, and I just forgot, you know, I just want to ask that everyone keep us in prayer as we go in, that you know, everything goes well, and you know, both Amber and the baby are healthy and safe, and that's about it. So. Myriah. It's okay, Zechariah. It's okay. Daddy's here. It's okay, son. Daddy's here.
So if you made it this far, that means you have stuck around towards the end of the video to see my thoughts on everything that happened for my birthing story, my labor and delivery story. Now, just like I said, this scripture about God reminding me to be strong in Him, you guys, that part where hubby was showing me being whisked away to the back to get the C-section done, I was so broken at that point. Like, I was just like, God, really? Like, throughout the whole thing, like, me dilating really slow, and then once I got to 6 centimeters dilated, I couldn't dilate anymore. I was just like, God, what's really, really going on? Like, what is going on? And so, you know, I was just so sad. And the thing about this doctor, I don't want to say his name, because I don't know if he wants his name to be disclosed, but the doctor that I had, I'll call him Dr. Job. His name will be Dr. Job. So with Dr. Job, what I liked with him was that he wasn't rude at all. Like, he wasn't like how all the other OBs that were coming in out of my room acting. Like, I'm mad that I didn't really do a lot of research with this pregnancy or any of my other pregnancies. I highly advise for people, if you can, if it's possible, if you have the money to afford it, or if your insurance covers, get you a midwife and a doula. Like, they are so important and essential for women giving birth. And look up the history of midwives and doulas, and then look up what OBs are for. One of my girlfriends, named Renela, she told me about a documentary called the Business of Birthing, or the Birthing Business, or something like that. And Ricky Lake is the person who did the documentary. I know y'all know who Ricky Lake was, who had her own TV show back in the day. And basically the video is involving how the difference between these midwives and the OBs, what's going on right now. And so pretty much to sum it up from how I take it, and like I said, I highly, highly advise you all to go look. Midwives, which are in the Bible, they're biblical, and that's why I'm just kind of like, duh, Amber. But anyway, they were specialized to deliver babies, to give birth. I mean, they could go, one of the babies are getting up, but they were really specialized and trained on birthing babies. And somewhere down the line from the Ricky Lake documentary, they were saying that midwives got a bad name, that people start calling them like witch doctors. People start thinking they were like witchcraft and, excuse me, a bunch of like evil stuff. And so the word got around. Of course, there's nothing but the devil, the enemy, spreading lies like he always does. And so midwives kind of went out of style pretty much, because people were like, well, my babies have a higher risk of dying. I'm not in a more secure hospital setting, blah, 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 blah. But the world should have stuck to midwives. Midwives are trained in birthing, and they are very patient. They are very loving. They're very caring and kind-hearted people. Now, I'm not saying there's no OBs out here like that, but they're not trained to be patient and loving and kind and caring. There's one OB on there, he's a male OB, and he said, look, I'm not trying to be mean or rude, which he was. He was like, but I don't get any joy out of holding a woman's hand and telling her to push and everything's going to be okay and to breathe and to take her time. Like, I was trained in surgery, not in comforting a woman while she's giving birth. And I'm like, wow. I mean, thank you for your transparency, but why do I want someone who's more trained to basically cut me or do whatever basically anytime necessary versus someone who knows the birthing of the baby, someone who is going to hold my hand, someone who is going to encourage me to continue to push and keep going. And the baby's almost here. Oh, I see his or her head. Come on, we can do this. Come on, push, push. But, you know, I want that support. And so I'm so mad I did not look into that. Some women, they want a C-section. I don't know why in your crazy mind you would just want to opt for a C-section. But some women, that's what they want. And that's what they get. But there's other women like me and tons of other women who are on that documentary who want someone that's loving and caring and that's going to want the most natural option for the baby's birth. So I'm going to leave that link below for the birthing business. And like I said, I highly advise, if you're pregnant, if you plan on getting pregnant, if you plan on having, you know, more kids later on in the future, look at this documentary because it is so, so important. Now, with Dr. Job, as you all saw again, I had to get the C-section done and I was immediately crushed. And so there were about two women that were there that I wasn't too really fond of. One of them was the absolute worst. And that's another thing about midwives and OBs. When you go to a center where there's multiple practicing OBs, I also advise against that. If you want more peaceful and subtle birth, you don't want to be seeing different faces popping in and out your room all night. You will want the same person you know that's going to be there for you. It's going to be delivering your baby. And so that's why I was really happy that Dr. Joe was going to be there for a 24-hour shift, because I was going to be with him from that morning to the next morning. So, you know, whenever Zachariah was going to make his appearance, he was going to be there. And so once I had the six centimeters dilated, six and a half, I wasn't dilating anymore. Like, I just stopped. And so I end up, after waiting, after I walked, he let me walk. One of the OBs didn't want me to walk, but I told her, I'm going to do what I want with my body. So Dr. Job told them to leave me alone, let me walk. I walked around the whole hospital with hubby. I believe, if you follow me on Instagram, I did like a little Insta story where we were walking around the hospital and we were laughing and joking with each other. And the contractions were coming. And then, you know, we stopped to eat and things like that. And then we ended up getting lazy and I ended up falling asleep while I was in labor. It's crazy. But yeah, all that stuff, I believe, slowed down my water once I kind of, you know, start eating and sitting down, stuff like that. And so, you know, time and time kept going by. And then, so they ended up breaking my water once I basically tried everything I wanted to do. I didn't want to get any Pitocin done because, again, that could rupture my incision from my previous birth. And I haven't even waited like 2 years after my last birth. So I didn't really want to try Pitocin. But I ended up giving into a little bit of Pitocin, like, I would say, what time was it? I would say probably about 1 or 2 o'clock in that morning. And I went to the hospital like around 7:30, I believe I said in the vlog. About 7:30, I got to the hospital, 8 o'clock. So from 7 that morning all the way up until like 1 or 2 the next morning, I was basically in active labor, but I wasn't dilating past 6 centimeters. So I tried the Pitocin. The lady told me, you know, because I was really, really nervous and scared about it. But then my nurse, she was so awesome. She had natural hair. She was wonderful. She looked so young and peaceful. You know, she really had me and hubby in there just smiling and laughing and things like that. And she was basically saying that, you know, she's the one in charge of the Pitocin. No one else is going to come in there and do whatever. That she can stop at any given time if I want to. That they have where they go from 1 to 30, I believe. So she started me at 1, and you can go up to 30, but we only went up to 2, I believe. And so once we got to 2, the contractions start coming a lot stronger. That's what Pitocin does. It makes the contractions come on like a lot stronger. But each time, even before with the Pitocin, what was going on with Zechariah was his heart kept dropping. His heart rate kept like down, up, down, up, down, up, down, up. And so it's kind of like what happened with Nehemiah too. And I'm kind of worried, like, okay, you know, there's something I'm not knowing, why my kid's heart rate keeps going down, you know. But the difference between my old OB and Dr. Joe was that my old OB just jumped into being crazy woman and just decided, okay, emergency C-section, without waiting to see if Nehemiah's heart rate was going to go back up. Dr. Joe, Zechariah's heart rate was dropping like, I can't even tell you all how many times his heart rate dropped, but I would say it was over 5 or 6 hours. And I know you guys might be like, what the heck? Like, what's wrong with you? Why would you let your child heart rate drop that much? They were just little dips. It wasn't like it was, and then it went back. It was like little dips of dropping, of him, of his heart rate dropping. And so the doctor was saying he was fine. Maybe you all be able to see Zechariah because he's about to go. Hold on.
I said, this is Mr. Zechariah. I just changed his butt. He woke up. He was wet. You gonna look at the camera? Say hi. Yeah, he's looking at. Hi. I'm the one who caused all that noise and caused mommy all that trouble. I didn't want to dilate past 6 centimeters. Baby, they're so precious, you guys. All the time, and they throw up on you, and they poop, and they pee on you, and they cry all night, and they have you up where you got bags on the eyes. All of it's worth it in the end, because they love you so much. I guess he's going to be my little co-star with me while I'm telling the story. And so, yeah, his heart rate kept, like, going, doing, like, really crazy stuff. And so Dr. Joe was just like, you know, after a while, he was like, well, you know, his heart is not, like, going, like, down too drastically. But we don't want to. Thank you, me too.
Yeah, he was just like, I don't want to keep having his heart rate do this.
So call me when you're getting off. You know,
okay.
All right. So Zechariah, see you later.
Yeah, see you later, Zechy.
Okay, so no interruptions. We just left out for work. But yeah. So Dr. Joe was basically telling me that we have to just go ahead and get, you know, we need to find out what's going to get done because we've already tried everything. I tried walking. I tried doing all these things. And he's like, his heart rate is still dropping drastically. And we need to find out what's really going on. And so, you know, he just like, I know this is just not what you want to do. I really, really want you to do the VBAC. But we have to get you dilated. We have to get this going because your water's been broke for a while and blah, blah. And we just want to make sure he's okay. Besides just that, even before my water was broke, his heart rate was dropping. It was dipping low. And so, you know, that's why they kept me in the very beginning. Because even when I was only like 3 centimeters, his heart was like taking little drops. And so I was just like, you know, I started crying. My husband, he started crying because he was just like, he saw all the pain that I was in with the twins. And also, like, the depression factor I was in, like, you guys, I was really depressed because I had the twins. And not because, like, postpartum depression or anything like that, but because of the C-section and the pain that I went through. And I can just tell that last OB, man, I'm telling you guys, she was just some wicked person. Like, I'm telling you, she was a wicked woman. And I just pray that, you know, the Lord gives vengeance when it's due. Because that woman really, really jacked me up. And I believe it was purposely. I mean, I don't know, but I believe it was. So it was just like, I was having all these flashbacks to last year. And I was just like, you know, I was getting so angry and sad and discouraged in the Lord. And I was just like, God, why would you allow me to go through this again? Like, why are you not hearing my prayers? Like, I prayed to you against this and you're allowing this to happen again. And so, you know, we prayed. I called my mom. I started crying before my mother. And she told me, stop crying. She told me to pray. And I was going to get through this. She prayed on the phone with me and my husband. We all had a prayer. And I just said, you know what, God, even though I don't know why you allowed me to go through this again and the pain things I'm going to be through, I trust you. And I just pray that everything goes well. You know, I hope everything goes better than the last time. And I just felt so defeated. I felt defeated because I didn't get what I wanted done. But that's what happens a lot in our lives. And especially with me being a Christian, I know that it's not my will, and it's not always going to be my plans. You know, just like I wanted my fourth boy to be my girl, finally. And, you know, God has other plans. And maybe later on in the future, he might, or maybe I never will. But, you know, I have to learn to be content with the Lord gives me. And even when I don't have much, I have a lot because I have the Lord. And so I just said, you know, okay, you know, let me do this. My husband, he just was looking so down, you guys. Like, I know you saw the little clip of him asking you all for prayer, and I was just telling him to be strong, you know, we were going to get through this, you know, everything was going to be okay. And so as they were whisking me into the emergency room, you know, I was just praying, and I just told God, you know, because I had this fear, like, you know, what if I don't wake up, what if he cuts me wrong, and I end up bleeding, you know, like, I just had so many different, like, things running through my mind. I know the enemy just wanted me to be in fear. And so I was just praying to God throughout the whole time. And so with the C-sections, which I think is kind of weird, but I mean, I don't know. They basically have you awake when they give you the C-section. And the last time I got put to sleep. And so I'm anemic. I told you all that. And so me being nervous and stressed and being anemic and all stuff, I was just shivering and shaking in the emergency room, in the operating room. It's really cold in there. And so I was just shivering and shaking the whole time. And so he started to cut me. And it didn't feel anything like it did the last time, like, where I actually felt, like, everything. I felt, like, little tugs and things like that. And so I was just so, like, nervous and nerve-wracked. I couldn't even concentrate. I couldn't even focus on anything that was going on. And Dr. Joe was so sweet. He was asking, you know, what was our wedding song? He was going to play our wedding song on his Pandora thing. So our wedding song was The Only Reason by J.P. Cooper. And so he ended up playing that. So, yeah, sorry I keep getting interrupted. There's so much going on this morning. Hubby just came back to the door to tell me something. But, yes, our wedding song is J.P. Cooper, The Only Reason. And anytime I hear that song, you guys, I start crying. But it was a good cry. It wasn't like me being depressed. It was a good cry. And I love that song so much. And so as he was playing it, you know, I was just trying to focus on the song and the music. And so I got through most of it. But then, like, towards, like, the very end of the surgery, I was just start freaking out again for whatever reason. I don't even know why. But he was just like, can you please just get through, like, another minute or two? You know, I'm almost done. I just got to do a few more things. I'm almost done. I really don't want to put you to sleep. He didn't want to put me to sleep because when they put you under the heavy anesthesia to make sure you don't feel anything, it takes a while for you to wake up. And he really wanted me to be able to see Zechariah as soon as he came, you know, as soon as he got him out. But you guys, like I said, I don't know what it was. I believe it just was from me shaking so much, from me being cold in there and just being, you know, just everything that was going on, nervous and all that. So I ended up getting put to sleep again. And, you know, when I woke up, I didn't even, you know anything. I just, you know, I know they were saying that hubby had to leave, and I just asked him, can they please just let him stay in there a little bit longer? So they let him stay in there a little bit longer. And so what my husband told me was, once, you know, they got Zechariah, the umbilical cord was wrapped around his body. So most of the time, the umbilical cord can be wrapped around the neck, but in his case, it was wrapped around his body. And so they were saying with each contraction I was giving and everything like that, the cord and stuff was squeezing on him. And so that's why his heart rate was dropping. And so, you guys, I'm not going to cry, but I'm telling you, like, when my husband told me that that's what was going on at the hospital, I started crying. And my husband said he cried once the Dr. Job told him and showed him what was going on, because he told my husband, you know, he saw what he was doing. And so he just was like, you know, this is what was wrong. The cord was so wrapped around his body, like, so badly that if I would have just kept trying to do it my way, like, I could have delivered a stillborn, pretty much. He could have died because of the pressure and everything from those contractions that kept hitting him. And then even with the Pitocin, which made it even worse, the contractions worse, it just would have been a disaster if I would have just kept trying to do it my way. And so, because Dr. Job, he didn't want me to feel like what the other OB said. There was another doctor coming on. And he said, well, what I can do is I can let you continue to naturally labor, because at this point, even at 16 weeks dilated, I refused all the epidurals. I didn't want any kind of epidural. I didn't want any pills or anything that they tried to offer me. I didn't want it. I wanted to do everything natural. So those contractions, boy, but I was getting through them like a soldier. I'm telling y'all, now that Pitocin, them contractions with that Pitocin, they were kicking my butt. But once they took me off, you know, everything, the contractions went back to normal. But, yeah, he was basically saying that the other doctor that was coming on, he'll let me naturally labor. And the other doctor was going to let me naturally labor as well, just continue to keep laboring through. But if 12, 1 o'clock hit and I still wasn't past 6 centimeters, they were going to have to go in for an emergency C-section. So that's why I was just kind of like, I don't want to wait to all the way to that point and then I have an emergency C-section. Also, at the same time, I didn't want another doctor coming on, and then he could be totally, you know, like, I just wanted to stick with Dr. Job. And so that's why I'm glad I stuck with him, because, you know, he was so sweet and so kind, like, and he told me, he said, I'm, like, the most midwife OB doctor here, like, you know, he wasn't a midwife, of course, but he just said, I have that patience and that care and that loving like them, and I'm not going to pressure you to do anything. I'm just going to tell you what's the best advice to do. And so once he told hubby, and he showed him basically much that, you know, the cord was so badly wrapped around Zechariah, you guys, I just really broke down to tears once I woke up, because I'm like, what if I would have just kept trying to do it my way? What if I was like, well, God, it's going to be my will that's going to be done, and I'm going to have this VBAC. You know, what if I would have just, I don't even want to think about that, you guys, but it's always good to listen to God, even in times when we feel like, you know, God, why would you let this happen to me? Why did you do this? There's a purpose and there's a meaning, there's a plan behind it. We don't know at the time, but there is. And so I was just so glad that he was fine. He was okay. You know, all the pain and stuff I went through that night, it was just all worth it because I did not want anything happening to him. And I'm just so glad he was safe, you guys. And so today, he will be 3 weeks today, I believe so. Yeah, he'll be 3 weeks today. And I cannot believe it's been, you know, 3 weeks. It's almost going to be a month. You know, next week will be a month. And I'm just like, you know, wow. You know, I went through so much and time is just flying. And so, well, Dr. Job, you know, he was really a sweetheart. And I have to go back in for my, to get my incision checked up and everything like that. I was supposed to go last week, but some things came up, so I have to go this week. And I'm going to get him a car and everything. Like, you guys, he was so freaking awesome. And I just really wish that, you know, he could do, you know, if I had to do any other surgeries or anything, if we do end up having one more child, I might have to get another one. I don't know. But he was definitely sent from God. I'm telling you, he was definitely a godsend because, those, like I said, it was another woman, another OB that was there. And she was trying to push for me to do all this crazy stuff, and he was like, no, leave her alone, like, you know, no. And I even stood my ground too, like, you know, you need to get out of my room, and I'm not doing this just because you want me to do it. You know, you have to know that it's your body, and in a sense, when it comes to them trying to push what they want on you, you know, don't allow any doctor, nurse, or anything trying to scare you into doing what they want you to do. And so I'm 3 weeks postpartum, and I feel awesome, you guys. Like, you know, they give you two painkillers, which is most of the time Advil and Motrin, and they also give you a narcotic, which mine was the oxycodone. And so for the first week, I was drugged up. You know, I was falling asleep, like, kept going to sleep because I was just, like, so out of it. But once I came home, I went to the hospital that Monday, and so I got released on Friday. I would say by that next Monday, I didn't need to take any more oxycodone. And I was so shocked because with the twins, yeah, I was on oxycodone for like almost 2 months straight. Like, it was so, I was in so much pain. With this one, it was like not even a whole week I was on it. And I remember when I was talking to him and I just said, well, you know, I'm a little afraid because of the pain and everything I'm going to be in. I've had to take care of 4 kids. You know, my mom won't be up here with me all the time. I have to take care of the kids by myself. And I said, you know, I don't want to be in pain for 2 months and have to take care of them. And he was like, 2 months. He was like, no. And I was like, what do you mean? I said, he was like, the most you'll be in pain is like maybe 2 weeks. And after 2 weeks, you'll be fine. I was like, oh, you're funny. Like, I was like, you're really funny, sir. And he was like, no, I'm serious. And you guys, I kid you not. It was literally like a week and a half, almost 2 weeks. And that was it. There was no more pain out there. And I'm like, this guy is like an angel sent from the Lord. Like, this guy is amazing. And, yeah, like I said, I'm 3 weeks postpartum. And I don't feel any pain, really. You know, I haven't had to take any kind of Tylenol, Advil, or anything in like 2 weeks. You know, I was only really on medication for a week. And he was also a sweetheart because I had diastasis recti from the twins, that little hump thing. And I think I still might have a little bit of the ab separation with the little hump, but it's nowhere near as bad as it was. Like, I'm going to see if I can show you all what I'm talking about. Let me see. Well, yeah, I'm going to have to show you all in another video. What I'm talking about. But I don't have it. And like, I actually have like a flat stomach. Like, my stomach is already flat and it's only been 3 weeks. And I'm like, wow, like, this guy's so amazing. Because like I said, with the twins, I had that nasty little hump thing that was sticking out, and I couldn't fit any into any of my clothes. Like, it was just a disaster. But with him, it was just like an angel sent from the Lord. And my recovery is awesome. I feel wonderful. I have no signs of depression. I have no postpartum depression or anything like that. Like, I'm just so happy. And I'm so thankful to have my little Zechariah. My little fuss pot. I know he's probably ready to eat. So I'm going to go ahead and wrap up this video. But yeah, you guys, it was his labor was tough. But it was such a blessing, and I'm so thankful. I'm so thankful that I had that I had, the doctor that I had. I'm so thankful that he was sent from the Lord himself, because even though, you know, God knew from the very beginning of this pregnancy that I was going to have another C-section way before I knew, and he knew I probably wasn't going to be happy, but he knew, he put me in the right hands. And so that goes for any woman out here, that if your birthing plan doesn't go right or anything in your life doesn't go right, God has plans for you. And it won't be your will, because God doesn't operate how we want him to. And like, but he works how he wants to, in his own time, in his will. And his will is always awesome and great for our lives, you guys. So remember this verse, Ephesians 6:10, and be strong in the Lord, you guys. And I hope you all enjoy this birthing story. Hope you enjoy my little Zechariah. He's about to have a fit in a second. And if you follow me on my social media, I'll make sure to put my social media tags up. If you follow me on there, I always post little videos and pictures of little Zechariah on my little chat and things like that. So, again, I hope you all enjoy. And I'll probably be coming to you all with like a 6-month review of him or when he turns a year. I don't know. And come back and show you all how he's developing, how he's growing, and things like that. So, thank you all for watching. And I love you all. If you are new, please subscribe to my channel. And if you are subscribed, thank you for riding down, holding down with me. You know, holding it down. And, for the lady who put me on blast, my subscriber who put me on blast, she was like, girl, where is labor and delivery story at? Like, for people who really know about you, we know this video was old. I was like, sheesh. Like, she really put me on blast. I was like, look, but I told you that in my channel update video. I said, after I have Zechariah, I'm going to be gone for like a good 2-4 weeks. I don't know how long I'm going to be out, depending on my recovery process and how I'm scheduling him in with the boys. I said, I'm going to be gone for a while, but I am going to be back with the labor and delivery story. And I was going to put out some older videos just to keep, you know, my channel going, because I didn't want to just be gone for 2-3 weeks with no videos. But, you know, the videos I was going to put up, they was going to be a little old. She was like, girl, we know this video old. We ain't stupid. I was like, dang, zang, girl, zang. But, yeah, so it's all good. I'm back now, y'all, so y'all be getting more updated videos. And yeah, everything's all great. So I love you all, and thank you so much for watching. Keep me and my family in prayers. Keep our little Zechariah in your prayers as well. And we will see you all in the next video. Bye. Zechariah, say bye. You say bye. You like, you better feed me, lady. You better feed me. Look.